In this video, we'll look at a series of graphs of systems of equations and determine the number of solutions. For review, when we graph a system of linear equations, if the graphs of the equations intersect, as we see here, then there is one solution that is true for both equations. So if we have one solution, the two lines intersect, and we can classify the system as consistent and independent. If the graphs of the equations do not intersect, for example, the two lines are parallel, then there are no solutions that are true for both equations. So if the two lines are parallel, the system has no solutions, and we can classify the system as inconsistent. And then finally, if the graphs of the equations are the same, or the two lines coincide, then there are an infinite number of solutions that are true for both equations. So if we graph both lines and the two lines are the same line, there are an infinite number of solutions and the system can be classified as consistent and dependent. So going back to our first example, the two lines have been graphed for us, and because there's a point of intersection, this indicates the system has one solution. We're not asked to give the solution, but the solution would be the ordered pair of the point of intersection. Notice how this point would be the ordered pair 3, negative 2, which is the solution to the system of equations, which means this ordered pair would satisfy both equations. Looking at our next example, again, we're asked to use the graph of the system of equations to determine the number of solutions. So both lines have been graphed, but notice how only one line is showing, and that's because both equations give us the same line with the two lines coincide, which means the system has an infinite number of solutions. Any ordered pair of any point on this line would satisfy both equations because both equations are equivalent. And for our third example, notice how the two lines are parallel and therefore the system has no solutions. There are no ordered pairs that will satisfy both equations. I hope you found this helpful.